Hey guys, Mr. L coming back at you with a brief video this time. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do electron configurations just by looking at the periodic table. So let's get into this video. So last video, we talked about quantum numbers and how these quantum numbers describe electrons within an atom. And there were four quantum numbers. After that, I told you that there are three rules to the game. We had the Aufbau diagram, or the Aufbau principle, so lowest energy orbital must fill first. We had the Pauli exclusion principle, which states no two electrons in the same atom can have the same set of four quantum numbers. And then we had Hund's rule, which states for degenerate energy orbitals, each orbital needs to get an electron with the same spin value before you start to pair them. So the way I like to do electron configurations is just by reading the periodic table, and I find that to be much, much easier. If you want to depend on the Aufbau diagram, by all means, you can use the Aufbau diagram, but I would rather just read the table. So I have this unique periodic table here, and you could see that it's separated into these four blocks with hydrogen up here kind of just sitting by itself. But the four blocks that we have is we have the S block. The S block is two groups big. In the middle here, we've got the D block, and the D block has 10 elements across. And we've got the P block here. P block has six elements across. And finally, we have the F block, and F block again fits between the S and the D block, and it's 14 elements across. So this is going to be a pattern. So if we were to just pick out an element, let's say chlorine at first. Let's try to do the electron configuration of chlorine just by reading it from the periodic table. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to locate the first period, and that's going to tell you the energy level. So first period is going to be energy level one, and then we hit the S block first. So the 1s is going to fill first. And then after we fill our two electrons from the 1s, next, we're going to hit the second period. So that's going to be the second energy level. So this is going to be 2s. This is going to be the 2s. So we're going to have 2s2. And then we come back 2. And then we're going to hit the P block. So this is going to be 2p. And then we're going to have to go all the way across. So this is 6. 2p6. Then after 2p6, we're going to have 3s2. And then we're going to come back 3p. And chlorine is 5. So the electron configuration from chlorine would be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So it's much easier to just look at the periodic table. It gets a little trickier once you hit the D block and the F block. Once you hit the D block, you have to subtract one from the period. So let's try to do one from the D block. Let's do nickel, atomic number 28. So lowest orbital fills first, lowest energy orbital. So we're going to have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2. And then you have to subtract one from the period, and our special table is already labeled for us, 3. So we're going to have to subtract one from 4, so it's 3d. And then we're going to come over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it'd be 3D8. So it'd be 1S2, 2S2, 2P6, 3S2, 3P6, 4S2, 3D8 for nickel. If we were to get to the F block, you're going to do the same exact thing, except you're going to subtract 2 from the period that you're in. So if you're in this, this would be the 4F. 6 minus 2 is 4F. And then again, you've got to remember to subtract 1 when you hit D. So it'd be 6 minus 1 is 5D. And then you would come back up to the 6P. So this is how we use the periodic table. So there it is, you guys. There's the easy method of reading the periodic table to be able to do electron configurations. If you found it helpful, smash the like button, send it to your best friend, and we'll see you in the next video.